Hey crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Zelbe. In today's video, I would like to start with liquidity mining. Before I do that, let me tell you, this video is no financial advice. I'm not telling you what to do. Liquidity mining is dangerous. If you do that, you could lose your money. So do your own research, do your own due diligence and decide for yourself. I'm just showing you what I do, and I actually ask you if you spot any mistakes that I make. If you see that I could have done something better, I would love if you can comment below the video and let me know. This way I learn. With that out of the way, I want to show you an article that I found on medium.com in the channel Osmosis. They have got an article, Liquidity Mining 101. It explains a lot of the basics, and I found that very helpful. Osmosis is a decentralized exchange on the Cosmos network. As far as I know, it is the first and so far the only decentralized exchange on the Cosmos network. The very first thing that I want to do is installing the Keplr wallet. This is a wallet that I can use on the Cosmos network, and thereby I can also use it on Osmosis. It's at Keplr.xyz, and I can just click get started. It will give me an option to install it as a browser extension on my Google Chrome. The same would work on Brave as well. I will install it on Google Chrome. Click add to Chrome. Add extension. That's already done. I will pin it for the moment and then set up my wallet inside. I'm going to create a new account, and from here on I'm not going to film it because I don't want to blur out all the things like the seed phrase, password and so on. The wallet is created. I'm done with this point. At the moment, the wallet is, of course, empty. What I can see in the wallet is that the base currency of the Cosmos network seems to be Atom. So Atom is a good token to purchase in order to do anything over here. I actually went ahead yesterday and purchased a little bit Atom on Binance. Binance, I can go to Fiat and Spot. And I see that I've got $1,022 worth of Atom tokens. I bought $1,000, it appreciated a little bit, that's good. But now I want to withdraw it in order to transfer it to my Keplr wallet. So I go to withdraw. Now I need the wallet address. I will open the wallet. And I click on this address to copy it. Paste it in over here. It says the network is Atom. That's fantastic. I don't need a memo. I will transfer all of my tokens. Click on withdraw, confirm, continue. Now I need the two codes. One is the code that they will send me via email. So I click get the code in order to get that started. I'm not going to film my email account. I hope you understand. I will get the code from over there, and I paste the code in over here. Now it needs the code from my Google Authenticator app on my telephone. And then we are good to go. So this is complete. It may take a moment because it needs all the approvals and the transfer on the blockchain. The tokens arrived. It took around about 2 minutes. That's good. Now I can go to Osmosis, to the decentralized exchange that I want to use for liquidity mining. I have to confirm their terms of service. And the first time that I do something with them, I have to transfer the assets from the wallet to over here, otherwise I wouldn't be able to trade them. So in order to transfer, I have to connect my wallet. Over here is the blue connect my wallet button. My wallet says I requested the connection, I will approve that, and now I should be ready to deposit. I go to Atom, because that is the token that I've got in my wallet, and click on deposit. Now let's do that and deposit. I have to approve that. 3 cent transaction fee is good. So let's go ahead. That was fast. Okay, let's just refresh it and have a look. Yeah, it's directly there. This is fantastic. Okay, I can go to their pools because I want to be a liquidity provider. So I want to pay something into a liquidity pool. So I had a look at some of the currency pairs over here, and I looked at the project and I looked at the price prediction charts. And one that seemed to be interesting for me was this XPRT token. So I want to pay into this pool. It says it got 50% Atom tokens and 50% XPRT tokens. Current APY depends on how long I bond my liquidity tokens. It's somewhere around 1000%, but now I need to turn 50% of my Atom tokens into XPRT tokens, right? Let's do that. So I want to swap tokens. I've got a swap token button over here. I've got 105 Atom tokens. Let's say I convert 52 of them. 52 Atom tokens. So let's swap that. Oh, I need Osmo tokens as a gas fee. This is a pity. I don't have Osmo tokens yet, but I see I don't really need them. If I say I want a low gas fee, then I could pay zero Osmo. So the team was kind. They introduced a zero gas fee transaction mode, which might be a little bit slower. So let's try that out. Maybe this takes a couple of minutes because I didn't pay gas. But then I will just wait. Oh no, it's already done. Fantastic. Okay, gas-free trading. I like that. I really like that. I should be ready to provide liquidity into this pool. Add remove liquidity is a button over here on top. So I want to enter all my XPRT in here. Let's paste it in here. All my XPRT tokens. They say I need 51.8 Atom tokens. I have 53. This is good. I can go ahead and add liquidity. Again, I don't pay gas fee. Approve. Good. Now my liquidity is $1,007 worth. Now I need to bond my liquidity tokens in order to really earn this yield. Let's click on Start Earning. And then it lets me choose for how long these liquidity tokens are bonded. This is basically a measure of how much risk I want to take. If I say 7 days, then I get a nice percentage of yield, but it also means I cannot withdraw it within 7 days. So when I see the market tanking or going up, and I don't want to leave my tokens in this liquidity pool, I rather want to sell them or swap them against something else, whatever, then I will not be able to do that within 1 week. But like I said, I had a look at the tokens. I believe in the next week we'll all be fine. Now let's bond them for 7 days. So I go to max. My available liquidity tokens are bonded for 7 days when I click bond. Once again, I select the low gas fee because I don't have Osmo tokens. And even this transaction is going through in seconds. I will keep an eye on this position. We'll put a reminder into my calendar. So in 7 days from now, I will check what this position has done. In the meantime, it doesn't really matter because I can't withdraw it anyway. And I will probably also make a video after a while to share with you how that goes. But maybe you want to do the same. I believe the sooner you go into such liquidity pools, the higher your chances are of returns. But like I said, this is no financial advice. Do whatever you think is right. However, if you want to give me any tips, if you have done similar things and you want to make me aware of other opportunities, or if you spot any mistakes that I have made over here, just let me know in the comments. I'm really grateful for that. And with that said, I hope I see you in the next video.